Today we are going to use Tinkercad to make a fantastic Clicky Fidget keychain, so let's get cracking. Today's project starts with a template. Please type bit.ly/clickykc and press enter. This is the Tinkercad project. Of course, it is set to copy and tinker. The tutorial is what I'm recording right now, so it'll be here soon. Of course, it is set to copy and tinker, so don't forget the golden rule of Tinkercad. Give a reaction before you copy and tinker. When you use copy and tinker, you get an exact copy of my design. Of course, right here, you can read all these notes. This will show where the tutorial will be. I do want to highlight a few things first. If you've never used Tinkercad before, these are my day one lessons. You should check those out to get your feet wet. If you want to learn more about fidgets, this is my fidget playlist. I also want to highlight these special parts. This is the hole for keys. Notice it is a bundle. This right here is the hole for my normal clicky fidgets and the cap. This one, I want you to be able to ungroup. So you'll have to copy this between projects. I'll have a tutorial that shows how to do that up here. This one we can store for later. To do that, you simply hit your creations. Notice I do have it clicked, and I'm going to hit create shape. You have to wait for it to load. Note this only works for the Cali keys. I'm going to give it the name keyhole. I'm going to lock the part size, and I'm going to save the shape. Just like that, this part is stored in my creations so I can always get back to it. You need to do the same step for the cap. As you can see, I'd already done this, so let me show you how to delete one. You simply click the gear and hit delete to clean up afterwards. So these two are saved. This one I'm not going to save because, once again, I want to be able to ungroup it at a later date. All right, so let me show you how this works. Our little keychain is going to have this shape. Notice this is just a cube with the hole cut out. And then we've got the caps where you add the letters. And we snap the Cali keys right in here. And this is a simple sketch keychain adapter we add in a minute. It is that easy. Let me show you how we get from this cube to the awesome finished shape. Notice when you click on this, its measurements are 21 on a side. I just want to show you real quickly. If you had brought out this cube and done shift stretch, which I do a lot, and you type 21 and press enter, check it out. This cube no longer knows its measurements. If you mess with handles, you break the parameters. That's something you need to know in Tinkercad. That's why you can look at this one now and see that I set it to 21 by 21 right here. I'm also going to set the radius to 4 and press enter, and I'm going to maximize the steps. That makes it nice and smooth like you see right here. Now remember, this is 21 high. We are going to subtract 4 from it. Simply bring out a cube. This one I'm going to stretch. I'm going to make it more than 21, and then I'm going to make this height 4 and press enter. If I select the two, choose L for align, click on this cube, and we want to center, and move it to the top. Now I can select those two and do Control G to group. We have just cut this at that exact spot. Now we can take this part and do Control D. I'm going to move it close, but of course we're going to simply do L for align. Click on the cube, center, and top to get it to the right spot, and Control G to group. Bang! That's the hole that you snap the key into when you're done. Now I am doing a two-letter keychain, so I'm going to do Control D and Shift Nudge to move it so that they overlap about a half millimeter. You can fiddle with that as much as you want. And now you've got to make your keys. I'm going to show you this. It's Control D. Move it out. I'm going to click on the little outline and move it out as well. Control D, Shift Nudge to get it in the right spot. And then I'm going to take the letter. Of course, I just used the basic fonts. You can play with these as much as you want. I will also add my text tutorials up here. You can check the bit.ly and bring in custom fonts. Simply do Control D and Shift Nudge to move that in place and make it whatever letter you needed. I'm going to just make this an R for fun so you can see how it works. I'll let you know quickly, these keys were built using the double trapezoid. You can see I used the numbers 17, 12, and 6, and then I sent it to Fusion so that we could get this nice rounded one. Same thing for this little part right here that I sent to Fusion as well, and I'll show you how they print in just a minute. Let's quickly add the keychain connector, and let's get this printed. I'm going to build my connector with Sketch. You can also build it with a tube. Notice I put it right in this 20 by 20 that is beside our part. That makes it nice to line up. I'm going to choose to move up 5 millimeters from the middle. I'm going to click press number 2, and I'm going to move out, let's say, 6 millimeters and then straight across. Click, hold, and twist to make that bezier curve. Remember we went 1, 2, 3, 4, 5? I'm going to do that same amount down. Click and hit escape to finish that part. Now right now it has a stroke of 2. If I want to make it a little stronger, I can do 2.5 and press enter. When you're happy with what you built, you can simply hit finish sketch. Bang, keychain connector. I'm going to choose to make mine 3 millimeters thick, and then watch this. Because of our curved shape, it isn't connected quite right. So I'm going to just lift it up, let's say 3 or 4 millimeters, and then I'm going to twist it, and I'm going to just use 15 or 16 degrees. Of course, when you print this, you can use supports, but I'm going to print it without supports just to show you that sometimes your printer can handle it. All right, so let's get this ready for 3D printing just so you can see what I'm thinking. I'm going to make this blue. I'm going to make the keys white. I'm going to hide this real quick. And I could make these separate colors, but I'm going to make them all the blue as well. Now, when we send this to the printer, I'm going to move this. I will let you know if you wanted to make this an OBJ file, you could. The only thing is when you're doing the keys and the base, it's going to switch layers all the time, so this becomes a much longer print. To speed things up, I'm going to do it separately. This part I'm going to do as an STL. Selected shapes. And I'm just going to swap the word from template to base. This will simply be the base part. And save the changes. Once again, you could do this all as an OBJ, but I do not like the zipped files. So I'm going to grab the two white parts, choose export, STL. Notice it was the selected shapes. And then I'm going to just change this word to key. And this will be the white part. So I'll put WT in front of it. Save. Let's hide those. I'm going to grab all the blue at once. Notice it says 4 shapes, export, STL. Let's steal that name from a moment ago. And in front of it, we're going to put BL for blue and save the changes. Now we can bounce to Bambu Lab Studio, create a new project, bring in that base. I'm going to use 0.2 standard generic blue PLA. If we slice the plate, check it out, 24 minutes. And let's hit print plate to send it to the 3D printer. Real quickly, I'm going to move this out of the way for a second, and let me just show you what is caused by us doing both at the same time. If this time I grab the white and the blue and choose open, single object, multiple parts, in come the keys. If I switch to objects and click on the white and swap it to white, bang, they look just like they're supposed to. But here's what I want you to see. If we slice this plate, you're up to 1 hour and 37 because of these filament switches. I'm going to back out of here to prepare. Let's delete this and let me show you these all by themselves. Once again, if we slice the plate, you're down to a 16-minute print. How cool is that? And here we are, moment of truth. Once again, these are Cali keys. I get a lot of comments saying, hey, do they work with other keys? And it really only fits this design. When you assemble, find the little edge, kind of looks like a hat, and it is the one we put that way. So just push it in and press it down and repeat that step for as many letters as you choose to build. Notice if you don't put it in straight, may take 2 tries. And then simply grab your letters and push them on the top. Bang, a custom clicky fidget. How cool is that? So a quick wrap up, friends. Hopefully you enjoyed the tutorial. Please hit that subscribe button. Also share with your friends. The more people we have, the better. Of course, since this is a scratch design, you're building it. You can sell these. Perhaps you can even pay for your 3D printer. Just making fun, clicky fidget keychains for everybody. Of course, if it was your first day, don't forget the day one lessons. They are awesome. They give you a lot of skills and they'll get you prepared for what you want to learn later. I do want to say thank you to everybody that supports me via YouTube memberships. There are three different levels of support, starting as low as $5 a month. With any level of support, you get early access to videos. I do also want to remind you that our members-only posts, make sure you keep an eye out for them. Also, a massive shout-out for all of my Patreon supporters. Love how that group is growing. We have passed 300 members. It is a fantastic messaging area where you can ask questions, post designs, gain skills. Of course, you can learn more with the bit.ly up above or the link in the description. Finally, friends, I want to thank you for watching. Don't forget every time you hit that like button, hype button, share a video, add a comment down below, or click subscribe. You're helping HLModTech get just a little bit bigger, which absolutely makes my day. Friends, have a glorious day and keep tinkering.